Universal Design for Learning in Physical Education. So what is Universal Design for Learning? Every student learns and is motivated by different things, depending on their background, experience, successes, and interests. Universal Design for Learning, or UDL, supports the various ways that students receive, process, and express information. For example, a teacher may have second graders chase bubbles for a warm-up with music. Some students may find this challenging and fun. Others may find it dull and boring with no challenge. Yet some may be terrified of the noise, crowd, and running into people. This is where UDL comes in. Universal Design for Learning directs the creation of the learning experiences to proactively meet the needs of all students. The three main components of UDL. Multiple means of representation is the what of learning. How the information is given to students. Giving information to students is just the first part. Showing the material in many different ways ensures that all students will be able to make sense of the content. For example, you can use students for demonstration, show a video of the skill or sport practice, or demonstrate the skill or activity yourself with the students verbally following along. Multiple means of engagement is the why of learning. The first thing to consider in this area is reducing students' discomfort and distraction and urging each student to take risks without being forced out of their comfort zone. Utilizing strategies to get students excited about learning, to help them sustain interest in learning tasks, and to know and regulate themselves. Multiple means of action and expression is the how of learning. How can you assess what the students know? How physical action can be incorporated? How levels of support can be added? How knowledge and skills can be expressed? In this area, give options for students to express what they know and can do. For example, when assessing how fast students can move from point A to B, you can allow them to choose the distance and the way they want to move, who they want to move with, the music that is playing, and the goals that they set. Help students set goals, manage information, and teach students how to monitor their progress toward learning goals. Unique and important features of UDL. Universal design starts in the lesson planning phase. It's not something that is added after the lesson is created. The variations are embedded into the lessons from the start. The universally designed options are for every student, not just students with disabilities or those on 504 plans. For example, when teaching striking, give students choice for equipment or how to strike. Have high expectations for all students. Generalization of UDL. It is important for students to learn the curriculum using the UDL approach. It is important to remember that the students should also learn the traditional equipment and rules for each sport and activity. By learning the traditional equipment and rules, the students know what they need to advocate for when they are involved in community programming. To review, there are three main components of UDL: multiple means of representation, the what of learning; multiple means of engagement, the why of learning; multiple means of action and expression, the how of learning. UDL starts in the lesson planning phase, has high expectations for all students, and asks all students to learn traditional equipment and rules, as well as the UDL approach. So now you know the basics of UDL. Try it out yourself.